Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. There are a lot of risks going on in space. At any time, you can hear one of the space agencies announcing that there is an asteroid headed straight for Earth. Some of them are just small ones, and they will announce that they will not get to the ground. However, there are others, such as the one in the news today, that are said to be large enough to destroy cities in a matter of seconds. There was one such asteroid headed for Earth, and it was said it would have made an impact in 2052. But something has changed, and this will no longer happen. So what really happened? On June 30th, the world celebrated International Asteroid Day. However, in the days leading up to the special day, there were still threats of an asteroid headed straight for Earth, expected to collide with our beloved home planet in 2052. This was a life-threatening asteroid, and if it were to touch down on Earth, there's no telling what extent the damage would be. It could even wipe out more than half of humanity. This asteroid was discovered by the European Space Agency. The asteroid, which was named 2021 QM1, was estimated to be about 5 meters wide. However, according to some calculations that were done by the European Space Agency, they suggested that the asteroid would most likely come into collision with Earth on April 2, 2052. However, a team of experts at the ESA, who were working in collaboration with some researchers at the European Southern Observatory, announced that in 2021, QM1 would not be coming into contact with our beloved planet for at least another 100 years. Hopefully, by then, the world would have developed a defense mechanism that would protect them from such a threat. The most interesting thing about this discovery is not that it was ruled out as a potential impact risk. It was how the agencies managed to gather the necessary data before coming to such a conclusion. The search for this data resulted in an intense hunt for a pretty elusive asteroid. But why would they dub it the riskiest asteroid known to humankind? Before we continue, make sure you smash that like button as hard as you can and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, space, technology, and so much more. The asteroid, known as 2021 QM1, was estimated to be about 50 meters wide. We're talking about something as large as the famous Arc de Triomphe in Paris. The first discovery of this massive asteroid in 2021, when some researchers at the Mount Lemmon Observatory in Arizona were busy observing the sky. When they first discovered it, it seemed just like any other asteroid, just another asteroid to add to the millions of known asteroids in the solar system, and yet another in the collection of asteroids orbiting the Sun alongside the planets. However, when some further observations of this asteroid were performed, so much more was discovered. For example, one of the things that was discovered was that the 2021 QM1 is an Apollo-class asteroid. This means it is an asteroid that is orbiting around the Sun and overlapping with Earth's own orbit. However, there are still thousands of asteroids that are just like that, so this was nothing new. In fact, Apollo-class asteroids are the single most common type of near-Earth objects, or NEOs. Later on, some calculations would reveal that this massive asteroid might actually pose a threat to our Mother Earth. When researchers did their calculations, they discovered that there was a risk of the asteroid colliding with the Earth in the future. But this was also not breaking news, because there are other asteroids just like that. There are always calculations like this being done fast, and when this happens, the ESA will add the asteroid to the risk lists. Later on, more data was collected, and more calculations were done just to narrow the scope of the orbit as they became sure of the asteroid's given orbit. This was when the scientists discovered that the asteroid was not as risky as they had put it out to be. But it did not mean that they would not do some more follow-up observations from other observatories all over the world. This was when a clearer picture was painted. According to ESA Planetary Defense Chief Richard Moisel, we could see its future paths around the Sun, and in 2052, it could come dangerously close to Earth. The more the asteroid was observed, the greater that risk became. And as the risk kept on increasing, so did the agency's continued gathering of more data. But something happened as they were observing the asteroid. As they were busy gathering data, the asteroid vanished. This was because its orbit took it closer to the Sun. The bright sunlight obscured the 2021 QM1 for a couple of months before it finally came back into the picture. In addition to that, it was also moving further away from the Earth. As Marco Michelli, an astronomer at the ESA Near Earth Objects Coordination Center, explained, by the time it passed out of the Sun's glare, it could be too faint to detect. However, this did not mean that astronomers did not have any other options. As long as there is a will, there will always be a way. In this case, astronomers decided to make use of a very large telescope known as the Very Large Telescope, or VLT. The Very Large Telescope is a special telescope facility that is operated in northern Chile. It so happens that it is one of the most advanced and productive astronomy facilities in existence. Since it began operations, it has led to numerous scientific discoveries as it went about its observations of the greater cosmos. This included the first direct imaging of an exoplanet, which was a planet outside the solar system. In fact, according to a 2010 estimate, among all the telescopes that are in operation at visible wavelengths, it is only NASA's Hubble Space Telescope that has produced more published scientific research. And soon enough, the James Webb Space Telescope will start making even greater discoveries. This was exactly what the scientists needed to hunt down the 2021 QM1. However, they had a very narrow gap. So they prepared the VLT, and it was on standby waiting to spot the 2021 QM1 the moment it emerged from the blinding glare of sunlight. Oliver Hynut, an astronomer with ESO, said, "We have a brief window in which to spot our risky asteroid." To make matters worse, it was passing through a region of the sky with the Milky Way just behind. Our small, faint receding asteroid would have to be found against a backdrop of thousands of stars. This would turn out to be some of the trickiest asteroid observations we've ever made. So, on May 24th, the VLT managed to capture the asteroid the moment it got in sight. Over the course of the night, a series of new images of the asteroid were taken, and it was now up to the scientists to sift through them all as they processed many observations and isolated the asteroid away from the background stars. The result was an image of the faintest asteroid ever seen. The sheer level of faintness was nothing short of astronomical, no pun intended, as it was 250 million times fainter than the faintest stars visible to the naked eye. That marked the end of the observations and the beginning of the calculations. It was now time for the moment of truth, as the calculations spoke for themselves. Even though 2021 QM1 is still an NEO and an Apollo-class asteroid, calculations showed that it was no longer a threat, and it was taken off ESA's list of risky asteroids. However, the list still has 1,377 asteroids on it. But what would have happened if the asteroid actually struck Earth? Well, the one thing we're sure of, that it would not have been the end of the world. According to some research done at the Davidson Institute of Science, the educational arm of Israel's Weizmann Institute of Science, if an asteroid that were more than 140 meters in diameter struck the Earth, it would release the amount of energy that is at least 1,000 times greater than that of the first atomic bomb. Something larger than that, more than 30 meters wide, such as the asteroid Apophis, would destroy the entire continent. An asteroid that is more than a kilometer wide would have caused worldwide cataclysm, which would now be considered the end of the world. However, for an asteroid as big as the 2020 QM1, which is only 50 meters wide, it wouldn't be as bad as the others, but there would still be a considerable level of damage. It could still cause damage for hundreds of kilometers. Fortunately, the 2021 QM1 will not collide with the Earth, indicating that we're safe for the time being. But there are still more threats being discovered by the space agencies, and there are many more to come. What do you think of the 2021 QM1? What effect do you think it would have had if it were to come into contact with the Earth? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, before you go, make sure you smash the like button as hard as you can and subscribe to this channel for more on the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, space, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.